Skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found. Leading from your window pane to a place behind the sun, just a step beyond the rain.
Somewhere.
clouds. Darken up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found. Leading from your window pane
to a place behind the sun, just a step beyond the rain.
Oh,
when all the clouds darken up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found. Waiting from your window pane
to a place behind the sun, just a step beyond the rain.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us today as we celebrate the graduates, the 2020 graduates of the College of Health and Human Services. My name is Kimberly Holmes, and I am the Associate Dean for Student Affairs in the college. And I will be helping guide us through this new way of having a celebration for our graduates today. I am going to start with just a few pointers to help us prepare today. So we are live broadcasting on both Zoom and on YouTube. So we have people joining in both ways. If you are on Zoom, we ask that you use the gallery view so that way you see the person who's speaking. And please mute yourself and keep your cameras off unless you are up to speak. For the folks on YouTube, we ask that you celebrate the graduates either on social media or in the comments. It will be live streamed there, and then it'll also be recorded so you can access it later, or if there's someone who couldn't be on today, then they will get to see you there, or that you can go back and replay it as much as you'd like. So on behalf of the college, both the faculty, staff, alums, the advisory board, and any other stakeholders in the college, I want to say welcome. We are so excited to celebrate your accomplishments. And although we really wish we could be together in person, we did want to make sure that we did our best to celebrate you in a way that was creative and personal. So the university graduation just happened at 2:00. We hope you were able to join that. If not, the good thing about being online is it's recorded and posted too. But then we wanted to do a live event, and then we also mailed to the graduates a box with just some mementos and things that will help you connect with the college. Hopefully you won't forget us. You know that we're thinking of you and that we want to celebrate you as best as we can. So those should be in the mail if you graduated in 2020. We are recognizing students from fall, spring, and summer, any 2020 graduates today. We're going to have a special focus during this live event on the doctoral graduates, because we're going to be able to bring them on the screen if they're here live, and we'll acknowledge them and their advisors because they're getting their terminal degree, all the work that was put in there. They have medals that they received in the mail as well. And then with the other graduates, if you're getting your master's degree, your bachelor's degree, or certificate, you will see your name on the screen. It'll roll through. Your department chairs will have an opportunity to talk and congratulate you all. And there's also slides for everyone. So on our college page, there are graduation slides that you can go to at any time. And all of the graduates were invited and asked to submit photos of themselves and quotes that they can share there. So you can go to that page or share it with your family as well. So just a rundown of what we're doing today. We're gonna start with a greeting from Dean Lewis, Dean Jermaine Lewis. Followed by a video recorded by President Washington for the graduates. And then we're going to have words from Dr. Kathy Huddleston, who is our alumni board chair. And then we'll move into the departmental recognitions. So with that, I am going to hand things over to Dean Lewis.
Thank you, Kim. And good afternoon, everyone. And thank you for joining to celebrate our graduates. Congratulations to the 2020 graduates of the College of Health and Human Services at George Mason University. Today, we celebrate students who have met requirements for certificates, bachelor's, master's, and doctoral degrees. With your degree, you are now positioned for the next step in your career, irrespective of whether you'll be joining or returning to the workforce or continuing to pursue another degree. I'd like to take a moment to recognize the graduates from the Department of Global and Community Health, the Department of Health Administration and Policy, the Department of Nutrition and Food Studies, the Department of Rehabilitation Science, the Department of Social Work, and the School of Nursing. I'd also like to take a moment to recognize our faculty and staff for all they do in working to ensure that you are career-ready graduates. So thank you to our faculty and staff. Well, this has been quite a year. This is the first time I've given congratulatory graduation remarks during a pandemic, and I hope it's the last time. And you're among the first pandemic-era graduates. Graduating during a pandemic means that you are a part of history, and no one can ever remove the distinction of pursuit and ability from you. Similarly, for your degree, a college degree cannot be bought. Rather, it still has to be earned, and it cannot be taken away from you. So use it well. Your accomplishments while at Mason are many: going to class, doing research, serving the community through clinicals, field placements, internships, and practicums, all while attending to everything else in life, such as family, friends, and jobs. Your ability to successfully meet academic demands in the context of forces beyond your control is witness to all you can do in the future. And it is a part of your living legacy of what is possible. I'm counting on our graduates from the 6 disciplines representing our college to work in support of rebuilding public health, its infrastructure, in such a way that it addresses contemporary needs using novel methods and tools. Join the college in working to support and deliver health equity. Graduations are happy times, so I'm concluding by reminding us that hope is on the horizon, not just in terms of new vaccines and treatments for COVID, but for thought and action aimed at righting injustices and ensuring health for all people. Knowledge, science, and practice will guide necessary action so that we have a world with health, not disparities, with safety, not violence, and with prosperity, not poverty. I believe that a committed and educated public health workforce is the secret sauce for delivering health for all people. So congratulations to our graduates, to your family and friends who provided encouragement and support along the way. Please celebrate your accomplishments, but please do so safely and stay in touch with the college and Mason. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Dean Lewis. So next up, we will have a video with greetings from President Washington.
Congratulations on achieving the highest degree in the land, and welcome to the company of scholars. What a wonderful accomplishment. This culmination of an arduous process of highs and lows, setbacks and successes have led you to this day. You reflect the outstanding George Mason faculty who inspired, instructed, and challenged you, and the outstanding staff who supported you. We are honored and humbled that you will carry on the noble pursuit of discovery and knowledge for decades to come. While doctoral students at Mason, you were also teachers, researchers, and mentors who made a positive impact throughout our university. Many students have discovered or refined their own academic passions because of your example and guidance. For that, we thank you. Each time you see doctor in front of your name, think about how you earned that title, because you have earned it. And we couldn't be more proud of you.
Okay, so that was a special greeting for the doctoral graduates. And next we are going to hear from Dr. Kathy Huddleston, who is an alum of our School of Nursing, and who also is the advisory board chair, the alumni board chair for the college. Might be having a little technical difficulty, but when Kathy comes on, we will get started there. Perfect.
There we go. Hello. As the chair of the College of Health and Human Services Alumni Board, an alum and a research faculty member, congratulations, class of 2020. The Alumni Chapter Board is a volunteer board of alumni representing all of the college's disciplines. This talented alumni board offers alumni, now you, various ways to stay engaged to include networking and social events, as well as career service and lifelong learning opportunities. As you graduate today with the paradox of the joy of the graduation and the holiday season, yet the continuing devastation of COVID-19 crisis, I want to make sure that you know that although you're graduating from Mason, you're not leaving us. You are now an alumni and forever part of the Mason family. We will continue to support you as you enter into this new world of work and independence. You are still part of our special family, being a graduate of the College of Health and Human Services, which is poised to be the first College of Public Health in Virginia. Another point of 2020 Mason CHHS pride for all of us to share. As you graduate and leave Mason as a student, take time to reflect over the past tumultuous year. Please know that we thank you for all that you're doing for your family, your community, and your health-related professions during these extraordinary times. Many of you will be soon working on the front lines of health, providing exceptional care and service for our community under demanding and challenging circumstances. I encourage you to take every opportunity to take care of yourself and your family and develop your resilience that you will need. We thank you in advance for the incredible contributions that we know that you're going to make. You are and forever will be a Mason Patriot. Use the resources here. Be an active alum. Did you know that there's over 17,000 alumni graduated from your college? And one of these 17,000 alumni are waiting in the wings to continue to support you as you advance in your health careers. Be sure to take advantage of these continuing resources. Look at the Patriots Helping Patriots website. Remember to update your contact information with the GMU Alumni Association. And please use your student GMU email account so we can stay in touch. As you start your career, the Alumni Board is here for you as you pursue your career path or paths. We welcome you to join us on the Mason journey to better serve our community's healthcare needs during this time of COVID and in the future. I look forward to looking back on 2020 and knowing that we all got through this together. You are graduating at a unique moment in history. Congratulations, class of 2020. Keep in touch.
Thank you so much, Kathy. Thank you for joining us today and for those great words of wisdom as an alum who has gone through graduating and going out into the working world. So now we are going to pivot to the departmental recognitions. For each, we're going to have the department chair start off with introducing themselves, and then they're going to call the names of the doctoral graduates. If the doctoral graduate is here, they will pop up on screen or have the opportunity to turn their camera on. If not, or if they're camera shy, we will keep moving forward. And then for all the other graduates, your name will scroll after that. You'll be able to see your name while the department chair is just giving some general congratulatory remarks. So with that, the presentation should be coming up on the screen now. And we will get started. So the first department is going to be the Department of Global and Community Health. And that will be Dr. Carolyn Druzbach. And there's the presentation.
Okay, I couldn't unmute myself, but so I'm Carolyn Druzbach, and I'm the chair of the Department of Global and Community Health here in the College of Health and Human Services at George Mason University. And we don't as yet have any PhD grads, so we will start with getting right into the names. But as most of you know, we are poised to admit in January our first class cohort of students in the PhD program. So it's a very exciting time for us. But at the moment, I just want to send my congratulations to all the graduates this year in the college who've completed their studies in the midst of trying circumstances. As Dean Lewis noted, this ceremony is being conducted in unprecedented ways, but importantly, you guys have completed your studies in novel ways. It's not easy to juggle school, life, and work in regular times, and to do so during a global pandemic shows your resilience and your determination. You and your loved ones should be so proud of all that you have accomplished during your time at Mason. But specifically, I want to send my congratulations to the graduates of the programs in the Department of Global and Community Health. That we have two students who are receiving their certificate in public health, 3 students receiving their Master of Science in Global Health, 48 students completing a Master of Public Health degree, and 192 students completing their Bachelor of Science in Community Health. Together, we are adding 245 trained public health professionals to the workforce. The importance of this workforce has been strikingly apparent over the last 9 months, now more than ever. Most of you graduates entered your studies before epidemiology and public health measures were household terms heard hourly on the 24-hour news channels, and before public health professionals were heroes in the fight against the tiniest of foes. You couldn't have asked for a more interesting time or a more vital time to enter the field of public health. Unlike some of the degrees represented here, you will not be able to see the impact of your work on individual patients and clients. In fact, public health is also often undervalued because it is inherently concerned with the health of populations rather than individuals. And the work is often invisible because it prevents rather than cures disease. That said, the work that you do will have enormous and broad impact on the health of all members of our community. To paraphrase Earl W. Stafford, you have chosen to dedicate your lives to doing good for others. So in closing, I wish you much future success in all your endeavors, and I look forward to the time in the not so distant future when we can gather safely together and celebrate your accomplishments. Thank you.
Thank you, Carrie. And once again, congratulations to all of the graduates from the Department of Global and Community Health. Next, we are going to have Dr. PJ Maddox, who is representing the Department of Health Administration and Policy.
It is very much a pleasure to be with everyone today and to celebrate all of our graduates, but as others have said before, especially the graduates from our own unique departments. You know, health administration and policy is a department that is often behind the scenes. And so we look forward today to telling you something more about them. Right now, however, and the graduates, the work they're doing, but right now we're going to acknowledge the graduates from the department's Doctor of Philosophy program in Health Services Research. We are very pleased this year, in spite of COVID, to have doctoral students who have persevered and completed a very rigorous program of study and dissertations, 5 of them specifically, in very important efforts that are contributing new knowledge and discoveries to what will be improving the delivery of health services and health policy in this country. So we are really proud of their efforts. Munir Ahmad, Doctor of Philosophy and Health Services Research, conducted a rigorous project related to immunization coverage. His department, chair for his dissertation was Dr. Panayotikit Santos, our director of the PhD program. Timothy P. Coffin, also now director of philosophy and health services research, completed a dissertation in detection model for early diagnosis of type 1 hereditary hemochromatosis. His advisor, chair was Dr. Farouk Alemi. Chanup Jung is now Doctor of Philosophy in Health Services Research, completed essays on providers' behavioral change in response to adaptation of the ACO model. His advisor or chair, Dr. Lynn Nichols. Annie Lasway, now Doctor of Philosophy in Health Services Research, use of Bayesian methods to predict the optimal revisit interval and the causal relationship between revisit intervals and kidney disease for Medicare patients with type 1 diabetes, also directed by Dr. Farouk Alemi in the department. And finally, Dr. Jamie Smith, Doctor of Philosophy in Health Services Research, an interrupted time series and data mining approach to assessing electronic prescribing mandates in New York, Maine, and Connecticut, directed by Dr. Panayota Katsanta. Dr. Moji Zari, Doctor of Philosophy now in Health Services Research, intelligent data generator, his advisor, Dr. Janusz Wojtuszak, and the Department of Health Administration and Policy. So while we have acknowledged our doctoral students, we now move on to students in our master's degree, and in particular, our master's in health administration. So while I bring you congratulations to all graduates, especially from the faculty and the staff, we want to tell you that it is with pride that we've watched each of our graduates master these very difficult programs of study. So we celebrate with you and your family today this important milestone, and know that you've not only had to cope with challenges associated living during a time of COVID, but also maintaining your studies and the hard work that it takes to actually get to this point. We are creating here the next generation of leaders and executives who are prepared to do transformational work in health systems. They are working as not only leaders and managers in these health systems, but as policy analysts and advocates in government organizations, and as specialists, including in areas such as health data analytics and as health data managers in health-related organizations. We know that each of these graduates is going to be prepared to work on some of the most challenging problems of our time, and feel very proud that we are preparing the next generation of workforce to bear on these problems. In our MHA program, there are some 31 students graduating today. We are especially proud that among these graduates are 18 from our all online program, and they are our first graduates in this program. Their capstone field projects actually benefited a number of health-related organizations, not only in Northern Virginia, but now throughout the United States with our online program. Their projects improved quality, saved dollars, and helped organizations actually improve the delivery of health services, in fact, ensuring the delivery of health services during COVID. Our master's students contributed over 6,000 man hours in consulting services during their capstone practicum projects. Our health and medical policy students developed capstone projects for an important public health advocacy organization in Washington, D.C. this year. And in the form of their policy analyses, that work is being used by that organization, not only for their advocacy work, but also the work that they do to shape health policy throughout the United States. Our 45 master's in health informatics students have undertaken projects that range from data analysis to improving public health. And finally, 131 graduates launched careers starting health administration, and 4 graduates in health data analytics certificates. So to all of our graduates and their students, congratulations. We're very proud of you and hope that you stay in touch.
Thank you, PJ. Next, we will have Dr. Marty Kubik, who is the director of the School of Nursing.
Thank you, Kim. Doing a great job. good afternoon, everyone. My name is Marty Kubik. I'm a professor and the director here at the School of Nursing at George Mason. Today, we have the pleasure and the honor of celebrating the success of our graduates in the School of Nursing here at Mason. Whether they are among the almost 200 who are new to the profession as baccalaureate prepared nurses, or are returning to a new role and new responsibilities as with a master's of science in nursing or as a doctorally prepared nurse. I'm going to take a little time here to introduce you to our 32 doctorally prepared students who graduated this past year. We're very proud of their work, their contribution to our profession, and their collaboration with our community, our partners, and our faculty and staff. So I'd like to begin with Heather Alsup-Morton, a doctor of nursing practice, and her advisor was Dr. Rebecca Sutter. Carly Yvonne Beltran Alvarado, she is a doctor of nursing practice, and her advisor was Dr. Carolyn Sutter. Peter Bison, also with a doctor of nursing practice, whose advisor was Dr. Anna Starr. Devane Chandler, doctor of nursing practice, whose advisor was Dr. Kathleen Scully. Tracy Davidson, doctor of nursing practice, whose advisor was Caroline Sutter. Kimberly Ann Dexter, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Rebecca Sutter. Catherine Hetherington Andrus, doctor of nursing practice, whose advisor was Dr. Cheryl Asian. Pam Fine, doctor of nursing practice, whose advisor was Dr. Tanya Haas. Simranjit Kaur Gulati, doctor of nursing practice, whose advisor is Dr. Kathleen Scully. Renee Hart, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Rebecca Sutter. Megan Harvey, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Rebecca Sutter. Tashanika Shalamis Pelem, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Cheryl Asian. Anisha Hicks, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Anna Starr. Jintanjali Jain, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Caroline Sutter. Lee Maria Kajowski, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Shanti Chang. Mary LaFonde, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Cheryl Asian. Catherine Moss, doctor of nursing practice, advisor also Dr. Cheryl Asian. Abdul Malik, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Kathleen Scully. Jessica McKee, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Shanti Chang. Francisco Batista Morin, doctor of nursing practice, his advisor was Dr. Rebecca Sutter. Laurie Navarrete, doctor of nursing practice, advisor was Dr. Kathleen Scully. Gracia North, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Tanya Haas. Vabhav Viven Patel, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Cheryl Asian. Christina Lay Rivera, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Shanti Chang. Jill Shields, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Tanya Haas. Nikki Soriano, doctor of nursing practice, advisor also Dr. Tanya Haas. Raina St. Germain, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Caroline Sutter. Sarah Beth Vandaginsti, doctor of nursing practice, advisor Dr. Tanya Haas. Teresa Vu, doctor of nursing practice, Dr. Caroline Sutter. Alyssa Wong, doctor of nursing practice, advisor was Dr. Shanti Chang. We are also very proud to introduce our Doctor of Philosophy in Nursing, our PhD graduates, who include Catherine Cardoni Brewer, PhD, advisor Ken Mio. Ann Mette Harding, advisor Kevin Mallinson. We also like to take the opportunity to acknowledge our graduates in the Master's of Science in Nursing and the Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Graduation, of course, is a time of reflection. Looking back, it's a time to reflect on the hard work, the dedication, and the accomplishments. And no doubt there were many this past year and the years before. Looking ahead, it's an opportunity to consider the next steps in your career as a nursing professional, to think about how you want to develop your practice and consider your impact as a nurse on the individuals, the families, and the communities you will serve. We know that nursing is a noble and an important profession. We reach all, we reach everywhere. And sometimes we reach out in a place that puts us on the front line of a pandemic. But no matter where we reach or where our reach takes us, As nurses, we educate, we support, we provide relief, we soothe heartache, and we share joy. Congratulations, graduates of the School of Nursing at George Mason University. Our best wishes go with you. Please stay healthy and stay safe. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kubik. As we finish out the last names for nursing, I just want to get Dr. Larry Cheskin queued up for the Department of Nutrition and Food Studies. All right, Dr. Cheskin, you're up.
Hello and welcome, everyone. So as we all know, this is not ordinary times, but I'm very glad that we're able to have this graduation, and I hope you'll have fond memories of what we're able to do given the circumstances. So the Department of Nutrition offers a master's degree, an MS in nutrition, and we're very pleased to acknowledge our graduates this year. As you know, nutrition is an area that can play a major role in other health problems and solutions. So even in this current pandemic, we're finding, for instance, that people are changing their diets because of the restrictions on being able to go out. And the COVID-19 has also been called the COVID-15, which is how many pounds you're expected to gain related to the pandemic. Of course, people who are more severely affected will lose weight. But in both cases, our nutrition is an important aspect of whether we do well or don't do well. And we're very, very pleased to honor the graduates that we have this year and send them out into the world to do good and help prevent things like we're experiencing now in the future. Thank you, everyone, and congratulations from me and from our faculty.
Thank you, Dr. Cheskin. So next we will have Dr. Rose Higgins, who is the interim department chair for the Department of Rehabilitation Science.
Hi, welcome everyone. And I'm here to congratulate our graduates, and we will go through our PhD student graduates who many of them had to do their dissertation via Zoom, which was unprecedented before COVID happened. And I'd like to congratulate them and thank them for their patience. Saad Al-Hamad, Doctor of Philosophy in Rehabilitation Science. His advisor was Dr. Randy Kaiser. Caitlin Ann Bryson, Doctor of Philosophy in Rehabilitation Science. Her advisor was Dr. Clinton Wootski. Dr. Brian Timothy Neville, Doctor of Philosophy in Rehabilitation Science. His advisor was Dr. Andrew Guccione. Carrie Rosen, Doctor of Philosophy in Rehabilitation Science, and her advisor was Clint Wootski. Emily Tinsley, Doctor of Philosophy in Rehabilitation Science, her advisor was Dr. Randy Kaiser. Leanna Christine Wooten, Doctor of Philosophy in Rehabilitation Science, and her advisor was Dr. Randy Kaiser. Now we move on to the Bachelor of Science in Rehabilitation Science. I want to wholeheartedly congratulate everyone, the graduates, their partners, their families, their parents. I want them to savor the moment. Their degrees have been earned during an unprecedented time. And unfortunately, COVID has now magnified the number of people in this country who will need rehabilitation if they are lucky enough to recover from the disease. I think we learn most from the challenges that we go through. All of the graduates in rehabilitation science clearly have resilience and they're poised to do great things. This is a unique celebration for you. And again, congratulations, you now join the ranks of the Mason alumni.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Higgins. So next up, we have Dr. Emily Ihara, who is the chair of the Department of Social Work.
Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of the Department of Social Work, I'm very honored to wish all of our BSW and MSW graduates our best wishes as you embark upon the next steps of your lifelong journey. Today, we are here to celebrate all of your hard work, diligence, and dedication to your field of study. And all of us are celebrating you today, your professors, your advisors, your mentors, your family members, and your friends. We all applaud you for your perseverance to make it to this point during this very challenging time in our history. Excellent social workers are needed now more than ever. All of the programs in our college are committed to creating health and human service professionals who will make a difference. And social workers make a difference every day in the lives of individuals, their families, our communities, and society as a whole. Our social work graduates are already doing great work in a variety of settings and making positive impacts for children, families, older adults, everyone who's suffering throughout this pandemic. And you all have the ability to help make changes in the lives of real people in the systems that serve them. As you continue on your career path, there are three things I'd like you to remember to always pay attention to. Take new risks and challenge yourself. Every day that we have challenges, we must overcome them. And every situation has a learning opportunity. Learn from every experience and take that with you as you move along. Then also, we want you to feed your passion and love what you do. Find what makes you happy so that you find joy every day in the work that you're doing. And third, nurture excellence in yourself and others. As you accomplish things, you always want to help others accomplish their dreams as well. So you want to find mentors, be a mentor, pay it forward. And throughout it all, please take the time to reflect and think about all of the causes and conditions that brought you to wherever you are today. Today, I hope you do take the time to pause and truly celebrate your accomplishments and appreciate those who have helped you along this journey. I'm confident that each of you will find a way to make your mark as a Mason alum throughout your career, and we all look forward to your contributions to the health and well-being of our communities. Please stay in touch. We look forward to the path that unfolds for each of you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Ihara. So with that, that concludes our recognition of our 2020 graduates. Just want to say thank you to everyone who joined today. We are so thrilled to have the opportunity to celebrate with you, even if we can't be there in person. Even though we know nothing compares to being there together and celebrating together in person, we do want to make sure that you know that we are very happy for you, proud of your accomplishments, and we hope that you stay connected with us in the future. I want to say a special thanks to all of the faculty and staff who helped put this event together. It took quite a bit of work getting the logistics down pat and making everything connect. We also have web pages that are posted up on the screen right now, and I encourage you to take a look at those. There are social media graphics that you can put up with your photos. There are links to your individual slides. There are videos that are from your different departments and faculty and staff. And speaker, like your student speaker is posted there. So please do check those out. Please do stay in touch with us. And to all the families, friends, my own family, folks who are joining, thank you for supporting your students through their time at Mason. We are thrilled that you could be with us even despite the circumstances. And we hope to keep in touch. Thanks. We'll leave this slide up for a few minutes. So if you want to get those websites down, you can do that now. Thank you.